Today we look at the Nickelodeon series, iCarly.
Which ran from 2007 to 2012, and it was one of your very first favorite shows, which was appointment viewing. So I got roped into watching it too at the time, but I have to say, I actually enjoyed it quite a bit.
Yes, I love Carly, and I like how Sam kind of works with Carly, and Sam's like this kind of, she's always eating food, and her mom goes into juvie a lot.
Right, Sam's this kind of wild character. They're a little bit like, again, I'll reference The Odd Couple because we're currently watching that, and they have, Sam and Carly have that kind of relationship. Now, of course, they do this web show called iCarly, and Carly lives with her brother Spencer, who's my very favorite character in the show. He's a lot of fun. He's very funny. Even Grandma laughs at Spencer sometimes with what he does. He's a great physical comedian. And she lives with her brother Spencer, and they have this really cool kind of studio apartment with an elevator in it and an upstairs downstairs. And the upstairs has the studio where they film the web show iCarly.
And I think that their web show is really fun because we get to see the show, but then we also get to see their web show. And they do a lot of crazy things, and it's really funny.
Yeah, and you know, it's a show within a show, and they do a lot of things, like you said, that's fun within there. And they've got some good core characters, Sam, Carly, and Spencer, who we mentioned. Then there's Freddie. And Freddie lives across the hallway, and he's kind of in love with Carly. But he's also...
At least for the first few seasons.
At least for the first few seasons, correct. But he's kind of he calls himself like, a tech geek kind of thing.
Yes.
And he does the camera work and does all the editing for the web show.
And Sam hates Freddie.
Initially, at least. For the first few seasons, right? So they get themselves into some fun little escapades here and there, but it's a sitcom, kind of old school, and this is another one of those shows that's been developed by Dan Schneider. Now, he's got a lot of stuff on Nickelodeon. He must have a development deal with them. He's a really good writer. He has tried to duplicate the success of iCarly through the years, but prior to this, he had shows like Kenan and Kel, there's Good Burger. He tried to duplicate this kind of with Sam and Cat and Victorious. He's got a lot of shows out there. I actually remember him from a show back in the 80s called Head of the Class, where he was an actor. He played a student in a kind of a high school drama with Howard Hessman as the lead. And he was very good in that back then, but he's obviously developed into a strong personality behind the camera. And so he develops a lot of these shows.
Yeah, I really like iCarly. Carly and Sam together are probably my favorite. I also like Spencer a lot.
Spencer's very funny.
And Freddie's mom is like a freak to Freddie in a way. She's always like doing weird things for Freddie.
Yeah, she's very overprotective, and she's always embarrassing him with her overprotectiveness. Mm-hmm. And that creates another sort of traditional situation in a comedy. Mm-hmm. And I think, again, like I said, Dan Schneider's roots are in comedy and sitcoms, and I think he has a good sense of what works in that realm. And he kind of goes old school with some of it, but puts a new method approach to it, a new world approach to it, or a new century approach to it, I guess we would say. Also in here is a character played by Noah Munch, I think is how you say his last name. He plays Gibby.
Mm-hmm.
And Gibby's a lot of fun. You know, initially in the first few seasons, he's a minor character, and he basically he takes his shirt off all the time. at very awkward moments, usually. But he actually develops into kind of a series regular after a while.
And he does iCarly with them sometimes, and he does a lot of funny things. Like, there was Carly's birthday, and they were doing a web show, and they're like, I don't want them to get me something like this, or this. And then the birthday pie comes out, and it's huge, and Gibby comes out.
Yes, he pops out of the birthday pie.
And he's like...
You know, he must have had some kind of impressionable effect on you because, you know, you were born after the show started, so you kind of caught up with it as you got a little bit older, but you had this blanket from the time you were really little, and you named that blanket Gibby for some reason, and that blanket is still named Gibby to this day. So you obviously liked his character. Like I said, he made an impression on you of some sort.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of good, you know, stock characters in here. There's a lot of relationships that are stock relationships in a sitcom. But like I said, he puts a spin on it. The creator of the show puts a spin on it. And then really these actors basically inhabited these roles and took them in their own direction. I mean, they really, really did flesh out the characters. Sam especially, you know, she really goes quite the distance with what they give her. And I'm sure the writers gave her more as she went because she really ate up what they were giving her and kind of expanded that because she's, you know, she becomes kind of the muscle to, like, she defends everybody if there's a problem and nobody will mess with Sam. Not that she's a bully necessarily. You know,
she has a butter sock.
Yes, she has a sock that she packs with frozen butter that she'll hit people. I know this sounds probably terrible, but it really is quite funny when it's done. She has a criminal past, but she also has a hidden beauty pageant past as well.
Right.
So you find out, you know, it's really interesting how they can take a character and still make it somewhat believable and create all these layers to it that really don't go together. She's got a criminal past, but she's also been in beauty pageants, but it's all hidden. You know. And Miranda Cosgrove plays Carly, and I only knew her prior to this from School of Rock with Jack Black, where she plays kind of the straight-laced student that doesn't want to bend the rules or break the rules. And she's very different here, and she does a really good job. She winds up really having to set up the comedy for the other three. I mean, she's basically plays this, you know, Abbott to everybody else is Costello. You know, she's the straight man. She sets up Spencer's laughs. She sets up Sam's laughs. And to a point, she sets up Freddie's laughs. And you know, Gibby being more of a character actor in this. But there's a lot of fun situations that they get into. The stories are pretty cool. They had some other characters like Lubert, who was in the first few seasons. He sort of disappeared after that. I was kind of disappointed because I thought he was a funny character.
Yeah, I thought he was funny and gross at the same time.
Yeah, he's not really the landlord. He's kind of like the manager of the apartment building where they live, and he's just a miserable person. He's a curmudgeon, but he's a younger guy. But he plays it with this, you know, this shrieky voice that he uses and everything. And I would always laugh quite a bit at him.
Yes, and even Freddie's mom started to go out.
Yeah, she was dating him for a while. Then he sort of disappeared off the show. I'm not sure why, and I kind of missed him after a while. I thought he was really good. But again, my very favorite character is Spencer. I identify with him a little more because he's older, and all the other ones were younger, so I think you would identify with them. But his physical comedy is impeccable. Jerry Trainor is the actor who plays him, and I haven't seen him in much else. I think he's very gifted, and I think he could do a lot of other things. But in this, I mean, he really, really puts... They all do a really good job. He's just my favorite.
Yeah, I like Spencer a lot. I think I identify more with Carly. I think
I think you would. I think you would. I just remember the one episode we were watching. I think he was he on skates? He was trying to be... And he was trying to get around the room. And I've never seen Grandma burst out in laughter before. But she did it this. I mean, we've watched millions of things with Grandma. I have anyway through the years. And I've never seen her laugh quite the way she did it.
And in that episode, I think Spencer was actually running away from this little boy, Chuck, who's an absolute devil.
Yes, he's a recurring character. He lives in the building and he terrorizes Spencer. So again, if you haven't tried it because you think it's just kids' fare, it has its roots in situation comedies of the past. Again, because the creator, you know, had some involvement in those types of things. And I think that there's a lot to offer there, you know, and I think it's fun. So this is something a family could sit down and watch together and everybody can get enjoyment out of it. You're not just kind of dealing with it. It was fun, you know. I wasn't really into it when you started because I'm like, ugh, you know, because I didn't know what to expect. But, I mean, the characters won me over and they really, the actors do a really good job in them.
Yep.
Anything else?
No, except for a see it.
Yeah, I'm going to give it a see it too. It's something offbeat and different. I think Dan Schneider has tried to recreate it several times, not necessarily with the level of success that iCarly had, because I think it's kind of lightning in a bottle. And, you know, I would check it out if I were you.